Hello, I'm Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. When it comes to playing guitar, every guitar player needs to have good strength and accuracy. Having these skills helps with your tone and how easy it feels to perform anything that you want to play. So in this lesson, I've got three drills for you, but one thing to remember is that each exercise needs to be done in the right way. They need to be practiced so the hand, the wrist, and the arm stay relaxed, because overdoing guitar drills can lead to injury, and injuries are one area that we absolutely have to avoid. After this, join me for the second half of the lesson over on my Patreon page, where I've compiled two example riffs for you that actually apply the ideas from the drills covered right here on this YouTube video. But first, let me tell you a little bit about my Handouts Collection ebook offer. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the CreativeGuitarStudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to CreativeGuitarStudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. The three guitar drills that I have for you will cover technique exercises for doing things like mastering major and minor third intervals. We're going to cover some stuff on hand stretches for accuracy. Also, I've included a speed builder drill as well. And that speed builder drill is basically for, you know, doing a multi-octave hammer on pull-off lick idea. But let's get things started with a major and minor interval drill that I have for you. It's going to operate with the 1-4-5 out of the key of C major. The drill itself goes like this. All right, so as you could probably tell there, we're playing two separations inside of a triad. The triad itself is the root 3-5. In this case, I'm playing it off of a C note here, C, E, G, laid out from the sixth string. And I'm just grabbing the low and the high, you know, intervals of that chord, which are basically a major third from C to E, and then a minor third from E up to the G note. And I'm doing that with the 1-4-5 of the key. So I'm working with C major to do that, F major as well. And then, you know, as I go across the neck, I'm doing it up an octave as well here. And then I'm taking it running again from the sixth string root, doing the C again, but this time jumping to the 5 chord of G. So I got G there, and then C into the G up an octave. So it's a nice little exercise. It's something you can throw a metronome on. Go really slow in the beginning, because you're probably going to have to organize all these separate shapes to cover the major and minor ideas. But keep the metronome very slow. I would say the initial goal on this one would probably just be like about 56 beats per minute or so, and keep it really slow like that. All right, so that's the first exercise. Let's take a look at the second exercise. We're going to be doing some suspended ideas to help you with stretching. It goes like this. So as you can tell there, with this one, we're setting up the doubled up power chords that we have on guitar, which goes root to fifth, and then again root to fifth, but in this case we're going to be looking at it as the fifth note to the second degree up an octave. So it's kind of a nice sound, you know, it's a very dreamy type of sound out of the guitar, but it also offers us a really nice stretch on the neck as well. So I'm setting it up off of the 8th fret here, 8, 10, 12 from the 6th string, and then I'm going across to catch an F as well. And with this one, I'm getting 8, 10, and 12 again, but from the 5th to 3rd string. And then I'm going to move ahead with that and get the G chord. So I got the 1-4-5, you know. Cool sound, eh? So we're going to be doing a lot more work with this in the Patreon Part 2 lesson. I hope you'll join me over there, because I got some cool sounds I'm going to share with you on how this stuff works in different ways to use it for a melodic aspect. But let's just also talk about how this would drift up an octave yet, because there's some interesting things that happen with the intervals when we go up an octave. And you can tell here I've got my, you know, perfect fifth, you know, whole step apart, but then I'm a step and a half apart when I go, you know, between the third and the second string. And then when we go from the third string, it changes once again. You know, now we have a step and a half between third to second string, but we have a whole step reach when we go between the second to the first string. That's the F chord there. If I move it up a whole step, I've got the G chord. So it's a really interesting exercise, and it's going to be pretty taxing on your fretboard hand. So at this point, I do need to tell you some things about staying relaxed. It's very important to stay relaxed with this stuff. I know in the title of the video, it says do this stuff every day. If you're new to a lot of this stuff, if you're still at that introductory level of guitar playing, maybe even intermediate level of guitar playing, you might find this too stressful on your hand. If you get some pain, you know, in this part of your hand here, maybe even, you know, from the stretches you got to do from the muscles in the wrist or even into the fingers, you know, make sure you just maybe, you know, knock this down to only perhaps about three times a week, maybe even twice a week, you know, just kind of gauge it on how relaxed and how comfortable your fretboard hand feels when you're doing this work, because the stress that it can put sometimes, you know, on the hand, on the wrist, on the arm, can be, you know, sometimes excessive for certain people. So just remember, stay relaxed when you do this. If you get any amount of pain or anything when you're working on this kind of stuff, take a break and just, you know, come back on a day or two later when your, you know, hand doesn't hurt anymore or something, and, you know, resume. And what happens over time is your hand just gets used to it and you develop a little more strength and ability. You'll get more power in your hand, and that's what we're after with these studies. Remember, we want to help those muscle groups in hand, wrist, and arm get pretty strong so that this stuff doesn't feel uncomfortable. And of course, what that's going to do down the road is help your tone and your accuracy a lot. So, you know, keep this stuff in mind. These drills are absolutely excellent for that aspect of playing. Now, I got one more drill I want to share with you yet, and this one is a speed builder. It goes like this. Let me slow that down a little bit there so you can understand it a little bit better. Those are the first two measures. As you can tell, it's a triplet hammer-on pull-off. And then I'm walking through a couple of notes after that. Some doubling up goes on. And then we kind of walk back into, you know, sort of like a defining note. The next two measures go like this. So that one's kind of easy in that group, because what's happening is we're just taking the exact same layout and we're doing it, you know, one time off the third string. And then one time off fourth string. And then what we're going to do with that run is we're going to drift it down into seventh position and just wrap everything up in that area between the fifth and sixth strings. And then, you know, wrap up is going to occur there into that eighth fret note on the sixth string. And that is our C. And that's kind of like, you know, the direction that we're flowing through here using all these natural tones out of that key. Get some really cool sounds out of it. And I'm sure too, what's going to probably happen in your playing is you're probably going to go and take this and start using some of these lines in guitar solos and all that. And that's perfectly natural. That kind of thing is a natural progression. You know, once you get an idea together that kind of sounds lick oriented, even if it's in a speed builder drill like this, what happens oftentimes is you get used to some of the position shifts and the way things sit on the neck, and you can start throwing these ideas into a guitar solo. So they're pretty handy. And that's why I called it a guitar lick speed builder, because it is kind of like lick oriented. It's operating in, you know, the way that we laid it out here anyway. It's operating in basically two measure chunks, and then you can, you know, kind of chop it up however you would like to fit it into your favorite guitar solos coming up in your playing. But anyway, guys, those are the three drills. We got a lot that we can do with those, not only from the perspective of helping you get better at some of the interval aspects, but also, you know, the big factor there is helping your hand stretches, your accuracy, the strength in your hand, and then just basically getting better at all this stuff so you get better tone when you're playing guitar. It all comes together really nicely in time, but remember, you want to play relaxed, make sure you're never playing with pain, and if your hand does start to hurt a little bit, take a break, you know, take a day or two off. Usually hand pain, if you stop playing and stop pushing yourself, it will go away in approximately 3 days and you'll be good to go again after that. And then, you know, you keep hitting it and your hand technique gets better and better and better, and you get more strength in your hand, and after a while you could just, you know, play for a long time and still feel comfortable with what you're doing. So anyway, guys, I I do have a part two lesson for this where we're going to be getting into more musical ideas over on my Patreon page. So if you're not a member over on my Patreon, for sure check it out. The address is patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. I'll have a two-part exercise going on over there that's much more musical, taking these ideas into a more, you know, musical context in a couple of short pieces. And then remember too, if like a lot of the ideas about this stuff are kind of like foreign to you and you really need an education on guitar, go and check out my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. And over there, I've got a series of courses that you can run through. I've even got a guitar technique course over there where you can run through that. I've got courses on guitar soloing though, music reading, ear training, acoustic guitar. And then on top of all that, I've got my core curriculum as well, where you can study things like, you know, the full introductory program. I've got an intermediate guitar program that's excellent. It'll really get your ideas together on the fingerboard. And then on top of that, I've also got an advanced guitar course that you're going to love. It'll teach you all your scales, all your arpeggios. It'll really give you a good understanding of everything on the neck. So eventually the whole guitar just feels like one big friendly place to you. So anyway, guys, I hope to catch up with you either on my website at creativeguitarstudio.com or over on Patreon at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video for the second half of this lesson. And in the bonus part two video, I have a couple of example riffs for you that apply the arpeggiated sus chord ideas and the speed builder guitar lick into some real world musical examples that'll take those drills and show you how they can be applied in a song. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you'll get jam tracks and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.